आचार्यवर्धमान स्वदाचार्य भगवंताम ये गुरुपरंपराम श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानाम आलयम करुणालयम नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्य कृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्ति भेद विभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्त देहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। यो ब्रह्माणं विदधाति पूर्वं यो वेदाश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तगुंहदेवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्येऽहं। शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। श्री चिद्घनगणेशाय नमो मह्यं सुखं नित्यं सप्रकाशं व्यापकं नामरूपेव अधिष्ठानं बुद्धिबोध्यं बुद्धेर्दुर्ग्यत्व निर्मलम् अपारं सर्ववेदान्तवेद्यं प्रत्यक्परं महः तदेव अहन्नमत्वन्यत् इति मे निश्चिता मतिः। So till 157, Avarta, we saw the Sarpa Nivrutti and Sarpa Jnana Nivrutti in three different ways in Anyatha Khyati, in Anirvachaniya Khyati Vada. In Siddhanta, basic principle is if the Adhyasa is there in the Brahmasthala, there is Adhyasa. Therefore, Adhyasa has to have an Adhisthana. Adhisthana is unknown. As long as it is unknown, there will be Adhyasa, Brahma. But Adhisthana Jnanena Brahma Nivruttihi. And Brahma Nivrutti is Padartha Nivrutti, Brahma. Padartha also, Vishaya, and Vishaya Jnana also. विषय ज्ञान निवृत्ति सो सर्प निवृत्ति एंड सर्प ज्ञान निवृत्ति दिस वी सॉ इन थ्री वेज वन इज रज्जु ज्ञान इज रज्जोच्छिन्न चैतन्य ज्ञान देयर बाय अधिष्ठान इज नोन एंड सर्प निवृत्ति टेक्स प्लेस देन सर्प ज्ञान गोज अवे ड्यू टू सर्पाभाव विषयाभावात विषय ज्ञानाभाव That's one way to which there was an objection as to how can the Vishaya Jnana, Brahma Vishaya Jnana go away because Sarpa Jnana has Adhisthana as Sakshi Chaitanya. Then we said it is possible. Another way we explain because Vishaya Abhava is there, therefore Sarpa Jnana Abhava. For that, the example is Adhisthana Jnana is not needed. Example we saw the Laya and Sushupti and Pralaya example. Because it is Laya Rupa Nivruttihi. In the Karana, there is Laya of the projected Karya. Another way we saw is the Adhisthana Chaitanya Sakshi. Sakshi Chaitanya, which is the Adhisthana for Sarpa Jnana, is in the Brahmasthala. And when it goes there, the Adhisthana Akara Vritti takes place. Therefore, Vritya Vachinna Chaitanya, which is Sakshi Chaitanya, becomes one with the Rajya Vachinna Chaitanya when Rajya Jnana takes place by Rajya Akara Vritti. Because the Desha is same. Desha being same, you cannot differentiate the Chaitanya, Rajya Vachinna Chaitanya and the Vritya Vachinna Chaitanya, which happens to be Sakshi Chaitanya, cannot be differentiated. Therefore, they are one. So Rajyavachinna Chaitanya being known by Rajya Jnana, thereby Sakshi Chaitanya is also known. Third way we saw is Triputi. In the Triputi, the Sakshi is the Chaitanya which lights up the entire Triputi. And the Triputi cannot be known unless the Sakshi Chaitanya is known. But Triputi being known, Sakshi Chaitanya is known. Therefore also, Sakshi Chaitanya Jnana Sarpa Jnana Nivrutti. So far we have seen bhinnatvam between notional difference, but still we have seen difference between rajyavachinna chaitanya and sakshi chaitanya. Now mithya sarpasya tajnanasya cha adhishthanam sakshi eva iti nirupayam. Sakshi chaitanya sakshischa asau sakshischa tat chaitanyam cha is sakshi chaitanya. So sakshi chaitanya or sakshi is the adhishthana for mithya sarpa as well as mithya sarpa jnana. Here we are not making a differentiation between chaitanyas at all. This is the real siddhanta. You can hold on to any of the three, earlier three, as long as we don't have any doubts, all those are fine. But then this is another possibility. Mithya sarpasya tajnanasya cha prithak adhishthanatva pakshe doshat tayoho ekam eva adhishthanam iti idani nirupyate. If you enquire into details of the earlier three pakshas, you have seen the Purvapakshi has raised questions. The Purvapakshi knows the Siddhanti, knows the Siddhanta, Advaita Siddhanta. Therefore, there are questions at the granular level, at the levels of the details. So one of these would be, you know, the questions would be lingering on. No, how can, you know, how can it be possible? Or we'll see what is the dosha anyway. So what I said is, earlier there may be some issue technically, and thereby we can say that the chaitanyas are not two at all, they are one. Mithya sarpasya tajnanasya cha prithak adhishthanatva pakshe doshat tayoho ekam eva adhishthanam iti idani nirupyate. Adhishthana is not different for sarpa and sarpajnana. Adhishthana is one. Tatra nahi, and that adhishthana is sakshi. Tatra nahi bahyarajyavachinna chaitanyam sarpasya tajnanasya cha adhishthanam bhavati iti shakyate vaktum. How do you say that it is? Sakshi. Let us say that adhishthana is one. What is that adhishthana? We have to inquire into the adhishthana of the sarpa as well as sarpajnana. If you propose a hypothesis that it is one, then which is that adhishthana? Nahi bahyarajyavachinna chaitanyam sarpasya tajnanasya cha adhishthanam bhavati iti vaktum shakyate. Iti vaktum na shakyate. Bahyarajyavachinna, because it is bahya. Yavanti jnanani jayante tani sarvanyapi pramataram sakshinam vashritya jayante iti niyamaha. There has to be pramatru, pramata. Jnata has to be there. Whenever jnana takes place, jnata has to be there. This is a niyama. Tasma, therefore what happens is that bahya rajyochinna chaitanyam na sarpa jnanasya ashrayo bhavitum arhati. Where is the jnana taking place? Jnana is taking place in the pramatru, pramata. The pramata is sakshi. Or pramata or sakshi. Pramata is considered different from the sakshi because pramata is antakkarana vishishta chaitanya. Thereby vishishta, if vishesha is there, we have to make a difference. There is a visheshana now. Sakshi does not have a visheshana. So pramata or sakshi have to be taken as ashraya. Whenever any unit of knowledge is taking place, there is a knower. This knower has to be either a witness who is just witnessing the knowledge, or he is himself the knower. So either way it can be said, if we make a difference between pramata and sakshi, technically there is a difference because sakshi is shuddha chaitanya. Shuddha chaitanya with the upadhi. So sakshi shuddha chaitanya, you have seen this difference earlier. Just a refresher, sakshi chaitanya is considered as an individual as well. Although non-different from Brahma, because antakkarana is there, but antakkarana is not the visheshana of the sakshi, it is the upadhi of the sakshi. Whereas in the case of pramata, sakshi chaitanya, chaitanya Brahma. So we can say Brahma with an upadhi of antakkarana is the sakshi. Any upadhi really is a sakshi. Pramata, jnata Manta, Shrota, all this, all these segmentations, namings are done based on this Sakshi Chaitanya, who has taken the Antakkarana and the Indriyas also as required as Visheshanas. So that is the difference between Pramata and Sakshi. You can consider either. There has to be Chaitanya principle backing, because Jnana, once someone says that there is knowledge somewhere, that knowledge can take place only in a sentient entity. Sentient entity means Chaitanya is there. Therefore, Pramata, who is Chaitanya Rupa Pramata, or Sakshi, who is Shuddha Chaitanya, we have to consider them as the Ashrayas. Therefore, Rajyochinna Chaitanya Sarpasita Jnanasya Cha Adhishthanam Bhavati Iti Na Vaktum Shakyate. Why? Because in Rajyochinna Chaitanya, although there is Chaitanya, there is no Antakkarana, so there is no sentience there. Rajju is not sentient, Rajju is Jada. And even when you objectify some other, you are objectifying not the Chaitanya, but you are really objectifying the Sharira of the other. Even if you say, I know how you think, so at a subtle level, it is an Anumana. But what is Pratyaksha is not the Chaitanya. It is not even the Antakkarana. Pratyaksha, what is Pratyaksha? Others' body is Pratyaksha. Not even the subtle body, it is only the gross body. Not even the Indriyas. The Indriya Golakas are Pratyakshas, which are part of the Stula Sharira. Thereby Jada, everything objectified is Jada. Tasmat Bahya Rajyochinna Chaitanyam na Sarpajnanasya Ashrayaha Bhavitum Arhati. So Rajyochinna Chaitanya, which is outside, cannot be the Ashraya for Sarpajnana. Then what is the single Ashraya for both? Sarpasya Tadvishayaka Bhramarupa Jnanasya Cha Adhishthanam Antakkarana Upahita Sakshi Chaitanyam Iti Abhyupagame Sharirasya antaha eva antakkarana pradeshe sarpopalabdhihi abhyupagantavyasyat. What other Chaitanya is there now? Rajyochinna Chaitanya, which is bahya, cannot be the adhishthana for both the Rajju Sarpa as well as the Rajju Sarpa Jnana. Meaning Sarpa Vishaya and Sarpa Vishayaka Jnana. Then what is left is Sakshi Chaitanya now. This Sakshi Chaitanya, who is the Sakshi Chaitanya? Who has the Upadhi of Antakkarana. So whether that Sakshi Chaitanya can be the Adhishthana for both Sarpa as well as Sarpajnana, Sarpasya Tad Vishayaka Bhramarupa Jnanasya, Sarpasya Tadvishayaka Bhramarupa Jnanasya Cha Adhishthanam Antakkarana Upahita Sakshi Chaitanyam Iti Abhyupagamye Sati. Iti Abhyupagame Sati. If you accept that, what will happen? Sharirasya Antareva Antakkarana Pradeshe Sarpa Upalabdhi Abhyupagantavya Syat. Sarpa and Sarpajnana, these two have to be explained. Adhishthana is one. It cannot be the Bahya Rajyochinna Chaitanya. Then can it be Sakshi Chaitanya? If it is Sakshi Chaitanya, then Sarpajnana taking place within is fine. What about the Sarpa Upalabdhi outside? Sarpa is cognized outside. This was our argument for the Akhyati Vadin also. Bhaya and Palayana. For Navyanayayika also. Rajju outside and Sarpa inside. That cannot be. And if Adhishthana is inside, then Sarpa, Jnana taking place inside, Sarpa will also be seen inside. Sarpa will not be seen outside. This is an issue with Bauddhas, Kshanika Vijnana Vadis also. They say everything is an Antakkarana Vritti. Not Antakkarana, they say Kshanika Vijnana Vritti. They don't say Vritti also, Kshanika Vijnana itself. We'll call it, interpreted from our perspective, it is a Vritti. Vritti is Jada. As though sentient due to Chaitanya being present. But Chaitanya is not segmented. For them, Chaitanya is segmented. and this Chaitanya being segmented or Antakarana, in the Antakarana, if there is Sarpa, then that Sarpa should be seen within, it cannot be seen outside. So this can be the objection, Sharirasya Antareva Antakarana Pradeshi. Sarpopalabdhir Abhyupagantavyasya. You'll have to accept that also. Natu Baihya Rajju Deshe. The Rajju is outside. In that Rajju Desha, which is outside, you cannot see Sarpa if the Sakshi Chaitanya is the Adhishthana. Sakshi Chaitanya is inside. Antareva Utpanna Sarpaha Maya Balena Bahirao Bhasate Iti Angikare. However, if you say, oh, Sarpa is within, because Adhishthana is within, Sarpa Jnana as well as Sarpa is within. But Maya Balena, this Maya makes it possible, it appears outside. Sarpa is inside, Utpannaha, Antareva Utpanna Sarpa, Maya Balena Bahirao Bhasate. Appears outside due to the strength of Maya. Maya can do anything. Maya sarvasya sambhavat. Ityangikare, if you say that, what will happen? This is the Purvapakshi. Purvapakshi will make this aropa. All these dvaitins come together and say, Atmakhyati matasiddhi prasajyeta. Atmakhyati is Kshanika Vijnani who says, there is Sarpa inside, Rajju also inside, entire Prapancha is inside, it appears outside. Maya Balena. They don't have Ishwari Maya. We have Ishwari Maya. They don't have Ishwara at all. But they'll say magically. Magically it appears outside. Maya is magic. So magically it appears outside. If you make such an argument, then Atmakhyati Matasiddhi Prasajyeta. It would be equivalent to Bauddhas, Kshanika Vijnanis, Tachya Prageva Khanditam. But we have discounted that. We have said it is not possible. We have negated that. Ittham Rajju Upahita Chaitanyasya Sarpa Jnana Adhishthanatva Sambhavat Antakkarana Upahita Chaitanyasya Cha Sarpa Adhishthanatva Sambhavat. So in this manner, the two Chaitanyas which I have discussed cannot be the Adhishthana for both Sarpa and Sarpa Jnana. Rajju Upahita Chaitanyasya Sarpa Jnana Adhishthanatva Sambhavat. Rajju Upahita Chaitanya can be the Adhishthana for Sarpa, but not Sarpa Jnana which is within. And Antakkarana Upahita Chaitanyasya Sarpa Adhishthanatva Sambhavatcha. Antakkarana Upahita Chaitanya is Sakshi Chaitanya. Sakshi Chaitanya is within. It cannot be the Adhishthana for Sarpa outside. Otherwise, Sarpa will be seen inside. Mithya Sarpa Tajnana Yor Ekadishthanatva Pakshaha Yadyapi Asangataha Iti Bhati. Thereby, what would be the conclusion? There are only two Adhishthanas, which are two Adhishthanas possible to be analyzed as one. Meaning, two possible Chaitanyas, which can be Adhishthana for both Sarpa as well as Sarpa Jnana. And both cases have been analyzed and ruled out. Therefore, what Mithya Sarpa outside, Tajnana inside, Tayoho Ekadishthanatva Pakshaha. Both cannot be one. This is what appears to be. Yadyapi Asangata Iti Bhati. It appears that it cannot be. There cannot be one single Adhishthana for Sarpa outside and Sarpa Jnana inside. Tathapi Vakshyamana Ritya Antakkarana Vrityupahita Chaitanyasya Ubhayadishthanatva Sambhavat Na Doshaha. But there is a possibility, as explained later, it will be explained next. There is a possibility of Antakkarana Vritti Upahita Chaitanya, which is Sakshi Chaitanya. Sakshi Chaitanya can be Ubhayadishthana. It can have Ubhayadishthanatvam. It is possible. Therefore, it's not this. Asangata dosha is not there. Impossibility. It appears to be impossible, but it is not impossible. How so? Tathahi chakshur dvara rajju desham gatasya antakkaranasya idamakara vrityupahita chaitanya shrita avidya sarpakarena tajnana karena cha parinamate. Which you have seen earlier. But we have seen that the Rajju Upayita Chaitanya was different and Sakshi Chaitanya was different, which was Vritti Avachinna. So what happens? Tathahi Chakshur Dwara Rajyudesham Gatasya Antakkaranasya. Antakkarana, which has somehow it's scrolling down again. Okay, sorry. The Indriya goes out and falls on the Rajju. Antakkarana goes along. Antakkarana has Chaitanya within. Therefore, Rajyudesham, Chakshur Dwara Rajyudesham Gatasya Antakkaranasya Idamakara Vritti Upahita Chaitanya, which is Sakshi Chaitanya. Sakshi Chaitanya is Ashraya for Avidya. Therefore, Sakshi Chaitanya Ashrita Avidya. Which has this Sakshi Chaitanya is outside now, not inside anymore. Of course, it is inside also because it's the same. We saw that just like water flows from a tap in the fields, it is through and through present. Same water is there within and without, meaning outside the field, at the source, as well as in the fields, out in the fields. Similarly, the Chaitanya, Sakshi Chaitanya, which is within, when the Antakkarana goes out, the Antakkarana cannot go out without the Chaitanya being there, and that happens to be Sakshi Chaitanya. Each of these, Antakkarana cannot do anything on its own, being Jada. Chaitanya cannot do anything because it is Nishkriya. When both are somehow mixed up, notionally, somehow mixed up, there is Adhyasa. Tadatmya Sambandha. Then what happens? There is a possibility of Antakkarana, Indriyas, everything acting up. Just by presence of Chaitanya. But this Chaitanya has to be there everywhere. Which is everywhere? This Sakshi Chaitanya, the Chaitanya which is making this Antakkarana Vritti possible, travel possible, Chakshurindriya going out possible, all this is possible due to that Sakshi Chaitanya. Therefore, wherever this Vritti takes place, Sakshi Chaitanya is there, which we saw yesterday. But we saw Rajyochchinna Chaitanya is there outside. Now, here what is said is Sarpak, this Chakshur Dwara Rajyudesham Gatasya Antakkarnasya Idamakara Vrityupaita Chaitanya Ashrita Avidya. Avidya, which is resting upon the Sakshi Chaitanya, which is Vrityupaita Chaitanya, which Vritti? Idamakara Vritti. Idamakara Vritti, that Idam Aumsha is Rajju. Rajju Aumsha, Rajju has Idam. So, the Rajyakara, when it is, Vritti is taking place, that time it has, there is something existence, therefore there is Idamakara Vritti. That Vritti, Upahita Chaitanya, which is Sakshi Chaitanya, is an Ashraya for Avidya. That Avidya changes into Sarpa. So, Idam Akara is there, but after the Idam Akara, the Idamakara has taken place in the Vritti, or Vritti has taken the shape of, not shape, Akara, we just say Akara. Akara can be anything. Idamakara, Vritti which has taken place, when it fell on Rajju, that time Rajju, the Vishesha Jnana has not taken place. Vishesha Akara has not taken place, only Samanya Akara has taken place, meaning something is there. Something is there, that kind of Akara Vritti takes place. That Vritti Upahita Chaitanya, which is Sakshi Chaitanya, it is Adhishtana for Avidya also. That Avidya transforms into Vishesha, which is Sarpa. And Sarpa Jnana also. Sarpakara due to Tamo Guna in the Avidya and Sarpajnana due to Sattva Guna in the Avidya. Thereby, Tatahi Chakshurdwara Rajyudesham Gatasya Antakkarnasya Idamakara Vrityupahita Chaitanya Ashrita Avidya Sarpakarana Tajnana Karnacha Parinamate Vrityupahita Chaitanyastha Avidya. This is a little irritating now. Just give me one moment. Maybe the mouse is getting pulled. Yeah. So what is happening is that vrityupeta chaitanyastha avidya. So vrityupeta chaitanyastha avidyayaha tamogunaushaha sarpasya upadana karanam tasyaha eva sattvagunaushaha sarpajnanasya upadana karanam. I mentioned this now. So the same avidya, which is sakshi chaitanya nishtha, that avidya transforms into two things now. One sarpa and other sarpajnana. Sarpa is due to the tamogunaamsha and sarpajnana is due to sattvagunaamsha. Evam sarpata jnana yor rutyupaita chaitanya meva adhishthanam. What is the adhishthana? There is no rajyupaita chaitanya at all. Need not be there. We can just say it is vrityupaita chaitanya, which vritti? Idamakara vritti. Idamakara vritti upahita chaitanyam is the adhishthana, and tadgata avidya transforms into sarpa as well as sarpajnana. Thereby it's an adhishthana for both sarpa and sarpajnana. Antakarna vrittehe bahyarajyudeshastha antakarna vrittehe bahyarajyudeshasthatvat tadvrityupaita chaitanyam api bahireva aste. So what has happened? Antakarna vritti is outside, and since it is outside in the rajyudesha, therefore tadvritti upahita chaitanyam api bahireva aste. That chaitanya, although it is sakshi chaitanya, it is outside. Also, you should say also, ataha tadeva sarpasya ashraya. That itself is the ashraya for sarpa, which is outside. So the sakshi chaitanya, which has gone out along with the antakkarana vritti, which has been drawn by the chakshu rindriya, going out and falling on the rajju, which is bahi, therefore bahya deshe rajju deshe bahya rajju deshe eva sakshi chaitanyam api aste. Ataha tadeva sarpasya ashraya, that is the sarpa ashraya. Now you cannot object that you should see the sarpa inside, because sarpa being the sarpa adhisthana being outside, which is sakshi chaitanya drawn from the vritti chakshurindriya, therefore the sakshi chaitanya is outside and sarpa ashraya it can be, and sarpa can be seen outside. Antakkaranasya swarupam yavat tavat deva sakshi swarupam api. So antakkaranasya swarupam yavat, wherever you see antakkarana, there itself sakshi is there. Sakshi should be there. You cannot have antakkarana working on its own. Sakshi, in fact, antakkarana goes away after the sharira drops off at death, stula sharira. There we see the chaitanya is no longer there, associated with the stula sharira. It goes wherever antakkarana goes. Sharira shariraantastha antakkaranamiya vritti rupena parinatam. This vritti, although it has taken place outside, it is the same antakkarana which is within. Within and without, there is no segmentation of antakkarana. Antakkarana going out does not mean completely gone out. The person will die if the antakkarana goes out completely. Antakkarana has not completely gone out, that is obvious. But antakkarana has gone out, that is also obvious. Therefore, antakkarana is pervading within and without. Shariraantastha antakkaranamiya vritti rupena parinatam tasmat vrityupaita chaitanyam sakshi bhavati. This vrityupaita chaitanya is sakshi, who is within and without now. Ataha tadeva sarpajnanasya ashraya, and being within sarpajnana ashraya, being outside sarpashraya, same sakshi chaitanya. Rajju pratyaksha kale rajju upaita chaitanya vritti upahita chaitanya yor eki bhavat. But when rajju is known, what has happened? Rajju pratyaksha kale rajju upahita chaitanya. Rajju upahita chaitanya, where the idamakara vritti took place earlier, but the rajjvakara was missed and sarpakara was projected. Instead of that, Rajju becomes known and Rajyupaita Chaitanya is Vrityupaita Chaitanya itself. So Vishesha takes place. When Vishesha Rajju Jnana takes place, that time the Chaitanya which is revealed is none other than the Sakshi Chaitanya, because it is one with the Rajyupaita Chaitanya. So Pratyaksha Kale, Rajju Pratyaksha Kale, Rajyupaita Chaitanya Chaitanya Vrityupaita Chaitanya Yor Eki Bhava. Since they are one, Rajju Jnani Naiva Mithya Sarpata Jnanayor Nivrittir Upapadyate. This part we have seen yesterday, that is same. What is the difference? The difference here is Rajju Upaita Chaitanya and Sakshi Chaitanya are not different. Sakshi Chaitanya is one that has traveled along with the Antakkarana Vritti outside. Therefore, it is not different. Adhishthana for both Sarpa and Sarpa Jnana are one. And when the Rajju is revealed, what happens is the same thing that we saw in the earlier Pakshas yesterday. Ekasyameva Rajyau Nana Purushanam Bhinna Bhinna Bhramadapi Sakshi Chaitanyameva Bhramadishthanam. Now the dosha which is there, which was mentioned, you know, dosha which was mentioned in the earlier Pakshas that we saw, when the Adhishthanas are different. What happens when the Adhishthanas are different? We saw the doshas and we refuted by saying Adhishthana can be one as well. If you see doshas, whatever doshas, if they are not resolved, consider that the Adhishthana Chaitanya for Sarpa as well as Sarpajnana are one. That happens to be Sakshi Chaitanya, not Rajyavachinna Chaitanya. Because Rajyavachinna Chaitanya cannot come inside. Sakshi Chaitanya can be inside and travel outside as well. So that is the difference. We resolved that. Now, ekasyam eva rajyau nana purushanam bhinna bhinna bhramadapi sakshi chaitanyam eva bhramadishthanam. Now, sakshi chaitanya being one, and we'll look at some dosha also. There are three people looking at Rajju. All these three people are seeing differently. Nobody sees the Rajju because it is dim light. When there is dim light, all the three people are seeing differently. One is seeing Sarpa while there is Rajju. The other sees Bhuchidra. The third sees Danda or Tailadhara, whatever. Jaladhara or... So all three are having Brahma. All three are seeing differently. If the Rajyavachinna Chaitanya were to get modified, then all three should see the same Brahma, have the same Brahma. So this is a well thought of objection. Ekasyam eva Rajyau, in a single Rajju, Nana Purushanam Bhinna Bhinna Brahmadapi. Different people are having different Brahmas. Sakshi Chaitanya Miva Brahmadishthanam. Then their Sakshi Chaitanya is the Brahmadishthanam. Kincha Ekasyam Eva Rajyuam Nana Purushanam Bhinna Bhinnaha Brahmaha Bhavanti. As we saw, there is possibility of various Brahmas for various people in the same Rajyudesha. Instead of the same Rajyu there. Yatha Kasyachit Sarpa Iti Anyasya Danda Iti Aparasya Mala Iti Ekasya Bhuchidram Iti Itarasya Tailadhara Iti. So, he has taken five people. One is seeing Sarpa, there is Rajju, one sees Sarpa, another sees Danda, third sees Mala, fourth sees Bhuchidra, fifth sees Tailadhara. Athava Sarvesham Sarpa Iti Ekaritya Eva Brahmaha Jayatam. Otherwise, let all of them see Sarpa itself. It is possible that everyone sees Sarpa, or it is possible that everyone sees differently. So this is a case where one may see different Brahma, one may have different Brahma, or one may all of them have may have different Brahmas, or all of them see the same Sarpa. Tatra yasya purushasya rajju sakshatkaro jayate tasyaiva tadiya vrityavachinna chaitanye kalpita adhyaso nivartate. Now, if there is a little light, maybe one's eyes are sharper than the others, he may see Rajju. Others will still continue to see Sarpa or whatever Brahma they had. But for this person, Brahma is gone. One is able to see Rajju as Rajju. Tatra yasya purushasya Rajju shakshatkaro jayate tasyaiva tadiya vrityavachinna chaitanye kalpitaha adhyasaha nivartate. Tasyaiva, not for others. Tadiya vrityavachinna chaitanye. Rajju sakshatkara, when it takes place, then tadiya vritti avachinna chaitanye kalpita adhyasa nivartate for that person. So tadiya is based on that person's vritti. The sakshi chaitanya is vritti avachinna. Sakshis are different. There are 5 different sakshis. Although all are sakshi chaitanya, they are non-different from Brahma, still they have upadhi of antakarana. So antakrana become the upadhi, antakrana modifying in the form of vritti, vrittyavachinna chaitanya, that sakshi chaitanya. In each of these cases, each of these people, we can say sakshi chaitanya is different. So tadiya vrittyavachinna chaitanya kalpita adhyasa. Adhyasa is kalpita in each of these 5 sakshi chaitanyas. One who sees the Rajju as Rajju, tadiya vrityavachinna chaitanye kalpita adhyasa nivartate. Bhu chidra is, bhu is bhumi, chidra is a break. So crack in the earth. So there is a crack, you know, broken ground. You can see the bhumi dries up and there is a crack. That can also take a shape of Rajju or Sarpa. So if Rajju can also appear as bhu chidra, meaning broken ground. There is a crack in the ground. Yasya tu Rajju Sakshatkaraha na bhavati. Others who do not have Rajju Sakshatkara, or you take one example, Yasya tu Rajju Sakshatkaraha na bhavati, tasya adhyasa nivruttir nasti. Now, in this example where you have taken multiple simultaneous Brahmas of different people, there also our anirvachaniya khyati should work. So this anirvachaniya khyati has been put to the test. Put to a test in the case of multiple people having different Brahmas and their own nivruttis or one's nivrutti, will it work there? Tasmat vrityavachinna chaitanyam eva kalpitanam sarvesham adhishthanam natu rajyadi vishayopayita chaitanyam. Therefore, the earlier 3 cases versus the case that we saw today, rajyavachinna chaitanya is the adhishthana for sarpa, while sakshi chaitanya is the adhishthana for sarpajnana. These are the earlier 3 cases we saw till yesterday. Today we saw as the sakshi chaitanya being the adhishthana for both the sarpa as well as sarpajnana. Today's study works better. How so? Tasmat vrityavachinna chaitanyam eva kalpitanam sarvesham adhishthanam. Sakshi chaitanya, if it is considered as adhishthana for all kalpita, in every kalpita stala you take the adhishthana as vrityavachinna chaitanya, then sarpa going away and sarpa jnana going away is possible for one, because his sakshi chaitanya is the adhishthana for sarpa as well as sarpajnana, whereas other sakshi chaitanya is the adhishthana for bhuchidra and bhuchidra jnana, yet another is danda and danda jnana, and so on. Therefore, in one case, if the Brahma goes away by knowing the Rajju as Rajju, then his sakshi chaitanya is known as adhishthana for the Rajju. Therefore, Rajju becomes known, Rajyavachinna Chaitanya is known, which is Sakshi Chaitanya. Rajyavachinna Chaitanya is not different. Sakshi Chaitanya, which is the adhishthana for avidya, whose tamasa ansha has converted into, transformed into sarpa, that is countered by the Rajju Jnana, which happens to be Sakshi Chaitanya. Jnana, because Rajyavachinna Chaitanya is Sakshi Chaitanya, so Rajju Jnana will reveal the Sakshi Chaitanya itself, and thereby Adhishthana being known, Adhyasa goes away, which happens to be Sarpa. Then Sarpa Jnana will also go away, because adhishtana is seeing. What will happen now? The person who was seeing sarpa will no longer see sarpa, which was what we saw in the earlier point. But the others will still continue to have Brahma. Now, this is a question that people ask for this, Nanaji Vadins. They say one gets mukti. Why are the others bound? Others should also be free because there is only one Brahma. One Brahma, there is avidya. This avidya vritti, avidya regarding Brahma, goes away by Brahmakara vritti. Then why do others continue in samsara? This is the explanation. Because Sakshi Chaitanya is the adhishthana for each and every jiva's Brahma and samsara. One has jnana, Brahma jnana, he is free. So Sakshi Chaitanya is the adhishthana. Anyway, so that is in the exemplified. We are jumping ahead. Natu Rajwadi Vishayopaita Chaitanya. But Rajyavachinna Chaitanya is not the adhishthana for Sarpa and Sarpa Jnana, Danda and Danda Jnana, Bhuchidra and Bhuchidra Jnana. Why? Rajyupaita Chaitanya se Sarpa Danda Adhishthana Tve. If you accept the Rajyupaita Chaitanya as the adhishthana for Sarpa, Danda, etc., then what will happen? Nana Purushana Bhinna Bhinna Taya Pratiya Manani Sarpadanda Dini Vastuni Sarvani Api Ekekasya Api Purushasya Pratiyeran. Then whatever you think it has transformed into, whatever has the avidya transformed into, which is Rajju Upeta Chaitanya Nishtha, then the Sarpa, Danda, etc., all these should be seen by each and everyone. You cannot have, everyone should have Sarpa Brahma or Danda Brahma, or everyone should have all sorts of Brahmas. You cannot have the person saying, oh, I see Sarpa, the other person saying, I see Danda. Either all of them should see Sarpa or Danda or Bhuchidra, or if you say that, yes, it is transferred into many, then let them see, all of them see Sarpa, Danda, Bhuchidra simultaneously. Tailadhara ityadi. That will not happen. Natu tatha pratiyate. That is not the case. Vrityupeta chaitanyasya mithya sarpadyadishthanatto vadi matarityatu na doshaha. However, in today's case where the Sakshi Chaitanya, which is Vrityupeta Chaitanya, if that is the adhishthana, then each one has their own adhishthana for their Brahma and Brahmajnana. Yasya Purushasya Vrityupeta Chaitanya yadvastu kalpitam tadvastu tasyaya pratiyate. Na anyasya iti vaktum shakyatva. We can say that Sakshi Chaitanya of this person, you take two, there is one Mitra and Chaitra. So Maitra and Chaitra. Maitra, Chaitra, Maitra is seeing Sarpa, Chaitra is seeing Bhuchidra. Rajju is there in the Rajju Desha, in the Brahmasthala. So Sakshi Chaitanya of Maitra is different. Sakshi Chaitanya of Chaitra is different. Because both have different antakkaranas, they become upadis for each of these. Antakkaranas are not same. Vyavaharika sattayam, antakkaranas are different. Therefore, Sakshi Chaitanya being different, adhishthana for each of these, for each of their brahmas, brahma vishayas as well as brahma jnanas are different. Therefore, they appear differently and their nivritti is also separately taken care of, if at all there is a nivritti. Other will continue. If one has a nivritti, Maitra has nivritti of Sarpa, he is he Rajju, and Rajju Jnana will also take place. Whereas in the case of Chaitra, the Bhuchidra continues to be appearing, he will have Brahma. Itam Baihya Brahma Vishaya Sarpadinam Tajnanancha Vrityupeta Sakshi Chaitanyam Eva Adhishtanam. Therefore, we have established that Sakshi Chaitanya is the Adhishtana for Bahya Vishaya as well as Antar Vishaya Jnana in the Brahmasthala. Swapnopalabdha Padarthanam Tajnanam Cha Antak Karnopaita Sakshi Eva Dishthanam. And you extend this to Swapna, which was brought about as an example earlier, because that is also Brahma. What will happen there? There also the same thing will apply. स्वप्नोपलब्ध पदार्थानां तज्ज्ञानानां च अंतकरण उपहित साक्षी एव अधिष्ठानम्। अंतकरण उपहित साक्षी, वृत्ति उपहित चैतन्य इज अंतकरण बीइंग मॉडिफाइड बट अंतकरण उपहित साक्षी इज द अधिष्ठान साक्षी चैतन्य बेसिकली। व्हाट इज द उपाधि वेरीज, वृत्ति इज द उपाधि और अंतकरण इज उपाधि। इन द केस ऑफ भ्रम वृत्ति इज द उपाधि, बट उपाधि फॉर हूम, साक्षी चैतन्य। सो साक्षी चैतन्य इज द अधिकरण सॉरी अधिष्ठान। एंड इन द केस ऑफ स्वप्न एंड स्वप्न ज्ञान व्हाट हैपेंस, अंतकरण उपहित साक्षी इज द अधिष्ठान बिकॉज देयर इज नो बाह्य देश वेयर द इंद्रियास कैन ट्रेवल एंड वृत्ति टेक्स प्लेस। वृत्ति इज नॉट बाह्य, वृत्ति इज ऑल विद इन विच इज अंतकरण मॉडिफाइंग बट इट इज नॉट ट्रेवलिंग एनी मोर, देर इज नो देश टू ट्रेवल। देर फोर अंतकरण उपहित साक्षी इज द अधिष्ठान इन स्वप्न। एवंच सरसद विलक्षण अनिर्वचनीय अविद्यायाः परिणाम भूत अनिर्वचनीय सर्पादीनां ख्यातिः इज इक्वल टू प्रतीति मीनिंग प्रसिद्धि मीनिंग स्फुरणम अभिवदनं च अनिर्वचनीय ख्यातिर इत्युच्यते। सो व्हाट इज अनिर्वचनीय ख्याति, सदसद विलक्षण इज अनिर्वचनीय, दैट विच इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम सत एंड असत, मीनिंग कैनॉट बी कैटेगराइज एज सत और असत। That is sada sad vilakshana, different from sad vilakshana and asad vilakshana. Thereby anirvachaniya, sada sad bhyam anirvachaniya avidya. That is avidya is anirvachaniya. And what is this avidya? Avidya is going to also transform. It is the upadana karana. Therefore, parinama bhuta anirvachaniya sarpadinam khyatihi. Not only is the karana, karana which is avidya is anirvachaniya, avidya karya is also anirvachaniya. Because avidya anirvachaniyatvam, sarasad vilakshanatvam will continue in the karya as an anuvritti. Therefore, parinama bhuta, anirvachaniya sarpadinam, padarthanam khyatihi, pratitihi, prasiddhi. These are all known words, puranam cha. So, jnana also is all, and the naming also, avivadanam cha. अनिर्वचनीय नाम रूप इज मिथ्या अनिर्वचनीय इन अनिर्वचनीय ख्याति, दैट इज व्हाट अनिर्वचनीय ख्याति इज। मिथ्या जगत आधार अधिष्ठान विषय का प्रश्न, सो द तत्व दृष्टि प्रश्न इज रिजॉल्व्ड। ही हैड आस्क्ड विच अमंग दीज फोर, आत्म असत ख्याति, आत्मख्याति, देन अन्यता ख्याति इन टू वेज, two ways in a sense we saw in the tippana, the navya nayayika mata also, or navya nayayika mata came in the moola itself, it was mentioned and elaborated in the tippana. So among these four, asat khyati, atmakhyati, anyata khyati and akhyati, among these four which is the best? The guru said forget about all four, none of them is right, anyata khyati is right. Anyata khyati we saw in multiple ways, whichever we understand, we want to hold on to that, we should hold on to that as the explanation for the example and then extend it to the exemplified. Mithya jagatah adhara adhishthana visheka prashnah. Now we have looked at the example, what about the exemplified? This prapancha is mithya, jagan mithya. Then what about this mithya jagat adhara and adhishthana? What is the adhara and adhishthana? हे स्वामिन प्रतीयमानस्य अपारस्य मिथ्याभूतस्य अस्य जगतः आधारः कः अधिष्ठानं च किं कृपया वद मे प्रभो। हे प्रभो कृपया वद, ड्यू टू योर कंपैशन प्लीज हेल्प यू अंडरस्टैंड दिस, व्हाट इज द अधिष्ठान एंड आधार ऑफ दिस प्रपंच विच इज यू सी सो सच अ वास्ट प्रपंच। फॉर सर्प आई अंडरस्टैंड, टाइनी सर्प, even a huge sarpa I understand, still tiny can compare to the universe, nothing, it is nothing, that kind of example I understand. But in our case, what is the adhishthana and adhara? Iti tattva drishti prichyati, tattva drishti ask this question. Pura prashnasya uttaram, what is the answer given? Mithya jagata atma eva adhara adhishthananja, atma is the adhishthana as well as adhara, not brahma, mind you, brahma is not the answer given. Why? Because Jiva Brahma Ivanapara. Jiva is Atma, Swarupataha, and Swarupata Brahma Bhinna. And the moksha is not sought for Brahma. Brahma is known as Ishvara. Ishvara does not need moksha, nor does the Jiva think that Ishvara needs moksha. Who needs moksha? Jagat does not need moksha. Moksha, whoever is seeking moksha, the construct should be, the teaching should be towards that entity. Tattva Drishti needs moksha. He wants moksha. So the answer given is very beautiful. It is in keeping with what is the Tattva Drishti's thinking. Tattva Drishti thinks himself as one Atma, Jivatma, who needs moksha. So the answer given is you, the Atma, are the Adhara. In fact, this is the entire process of teaching, especially of Drishti Srishtivada. Anyway, it is going towards that. I am just introducing terms so that we see in all perspectives possible. We should not hold on to only one perspective. Prakriyas vary, but we should land, we can land, and we should be able to land on the same tattva from various prakriyas. Here, he shishya, who needs moksha, he shishya, tvan nijaswarupa jnanat, is meaning what? Atmanaha brahma rupena ajnanat. Atma, which is your real pratyagatma, real swarupa is brahma. Brahma rupena ajnana, atmana. That is tvan nijaswarupa, real swarupa. Your own real swarupa is what? Brahma rupa. Tasya ajnana is tvan nijaswarupa ajnana. Tava idam mithya jagat pratibhasate. Mithya jagat kasya pratibhasate, tava pratibhasate. You are seeing it. So, mithya jagata adhara adhishtana, who is the adhara adhishtana? You who is the drashta of this mithya jagat, you are the adhishtana. Look at the construct of the sentence. Tvan nijaswarupa ajnana. Because of you are not knowing your own reality as Brahma, that is the hetu, hetau panchami. Tava idam mithya jagat pratibhasate. So, yasya mithya jagat pratibhasate, tasyeva atma is nijaswarupam. Adhisthanam adharaha cha. That is the general answer. Ataha tvameva asya jagataha adhara adhisthanam cha. Look at the reasoning. Since it appears to you, you are the adhisthanam. Who sees the swapna? So, you see the swapna, I don't see the swapna, then how can I be the adhara or someone else be the adhara and adhishtana? You are the adhishtana and adhara for the swapna prapancha, including each and every micro and macro entity in the swapna. This entire subjective objective world in the sentient insentient world, moving unmoving world in the swapna prapancha is cognized by you. Whoever cognizes is the Adhara and Adhishthana. Similarly, Swapnavat Mithyatvam Jagrat Prapanchasya Api. Therefore, Jagrat Prapancha Mithya Jagat is apparent to you. Whoever it is apparent to, he or she, qualifying with the Vyavaharika Drishti gender. Otherwise, there is no gender. That Atma really, he and she is Mithya, because that he, she, all these nama rupas are part of the prapancha. If he sees it or she sees it, that I am he or she is also apparent to whom? The gender is not apparent to the sharira. The sharira has gender which is apparent to others. Who other? Who is that other? That other is the pratyagatma really. Vritti is taking place in the antakkarana. Antakkarana is also objectified by whom? So, the body, mind, sense complex is objectified by whosoever, not only one's own, others. Not only others, one's own as well. Because all that is objectified is Jagat. Drik Drishya Viveka. Yasya Pratibhati. सह एव आधार अधिष्ठानं च रज्ज्वज्ञान रज्ज्वज्ञानात् मिथ्याभूत सर्प प्रतिभासते. नाउ दैट एग्जांपल इज एक्सटेंडेड इनटू एक्सेम्प्लीफाइड. सो हियर ड्यू टू रज्ज्वज्ञान द मिथ्याभूत सर्प इज शाइन्स फोर्थ अपीयर्स प्रतिभासा इज देयर आभासा इट इज आभासा रियली. सिमिलरली इज दिस प्रपंच विल सी मोर इन द नेक्स्ट पार्ट. सो द एग्जांपल इज एक्सटेंडेड टू द एग्जांप्लिफाइड एंड देन द आधार एंड अधिष्ठान इज इंक्वायर्ड इनटू. सुखम नित्यम सुप्रकाशम व्यापक नाम रूप अधिष्ठान बुद्धि बोध्यम बुद्धेरुक्यत्व निर्मलम अपारम सर्व वेदांत वेद्यम प्रत्येक परम महा तदेव अन्नमत्व निति मे निश्चिता मति. I'll see you in the next part. I'm late for the next part. Namaste.
हरि ओम.